Good morning, students. Welcome in your English class. Today, our chapter is Why Meena Could Not Sleep. Thought of the day is, person who works hard never fails. Means, जो व्यक्ति कठिन मेहनत करते हैं वो कभी भी फेल नहीं होते, कभी असफल नहीं होते हैं. तो हमें अपना काम बहुत ईमानदारी से और मेहनत से करना चाहिए. टुडे वी विल लर्न पंचुएशन. स्टूडेंट्स, इन स्पीकिंग वी यूज पॉजेस एंड द पिच ऑफ द वॉइस टू मेक व्हाट वी से क्लियर. पंचुएशन plays a similar role in writing, making it easier to read. Students, हम जब बात करते हैं या बोलते हैं तो हमें कहाँ पर रुकना है, किस बात को कितनी जोर से कहना है, वो हम इफ़ेक्ट अपने बातों में डालते हैं. ठीक इसी तरीके से पंक्चुएशन जो है वो इसी तरीके का काम राइटिंग में करता है, जिससे रीड करने में यानी पढ़ने में आसानी हो सके. Punctuation is the system of symbols that we use to separate written sentences and parts of sentences and to make their meaning clear. Each symbol is called a punctuation. Punctuation में use किए गए symbol लिखे गए वाक्यों को और वाक्य के भागों को अलग अलग करते हैं, जिससे उनका अर्थ और अधिक क्लियर हो जाता है. हर सिंबल पंचुएशन कहलाता है. मोस्ट कॉमन पंचुएशन मार्क्स इन इंग्लिश आर कैपिटल लेटर्स, फुल स्टॉप्स, क्वेश्चन मार्क्स, कॉमास, कॉलन्स एंड सेमी कॉलन्स, एक्सक्लेमेशन मार्क्स एंड क्यूटेशन मार्क्स. बट नाउ वी विल डिस्कस ओनली फुल स्टॉप एंड कैपिटल लेटर्स. Sign of question mark is this and sign of full stop is this. A sentence begins with capital letter and ends with full stop. Students, एक sentence, एक वाक्य हमेशा capital letter से शुरू होता है और इसकी समाप्ति full stop से होती है. A pronoun I is written always in a capital letter wherever it appears. Means, a pronoun I हमेशा capital में लिखा जाता है, ये जहाँ भी sentence में दिखाई दे. A proper noun always begins with a capital letter. Now, you would have a question, what is proper noun? A proper noun is a specific name for a particular person, place or thing. Proper nouns are always capitalized in English, no matter where they fall in a sentence, because they endow nouns with a specific name. They are also sometimes called proper noun. Students, proper noun particular व्यक्ति का name, जगह का name या फिर वस्तु का नेम होता है. प्रॉपर नाउन हमेशा इंग्लिश में कैपिटल में लिखा जाता है और इससे फ़र्क नहीं पड़ता कि वो सेंटेंस में कहाँ पर आता, और इन नेम्स को ही प्रॉपर नाउन के नाम से जाना जाता है. एज एग्जांपल, पर्सन नेम मींस लता, टीना एक्सेट्रा. प्लेस नेम लाइक मनी मंदिर, मोरबी एक्सेट्रा. थिंग्स नेम like sunsilk, किसान जैम etc. means student, व्यक्ति का नाम, जगह का नाम और किसी भी प्रोडक्ट का नेम हम हमेशा कैपिटल में ही लिखते हैं, चाहे वो सेंटेंस के मध्य में आए, लास्ट में आए या फिर शुरुआत में आए. So students, today we will do our work in English textbook. So students, ready for it? Take out page number 7. Punctuation.
Mother knew that I had eaten the cake. In this sentence, we look that its beginning letter is in capital letter. And at the last, we put a full stop. And in other sentence, I like to sing and dance. In this sentence, the beginning letter is in capital letter. And at the end of this sentence, we put full stop. Now look at another sentence. Polly is going to New Delhi in January. In this sentence, January is a proper noun. It is a month name. So that it is in capital letter. Delhi is a New Delhi. New Delhi is a place name. It is a proper name, so that both words begin with capital letter. And this sentence begin with this word, so its beginning letter is also in capital letter. And at the last of this sentence, here we put full stop. Now we will start our work in our textbook. Use capital letters and full stops in the correct places in these sentences. So student, here are 6 sentences. We do not write its answer in given place. So we will look question in our textbook and we will write its answer in our fair notebook. So student, take out your fair notebook. Now in your fair notebook, you will write down in its right side CW. Hope you will know what is the full form of CW. Classwork. Okay. Now we will write here the heading in our first line, punctuation. PUNCTUATION, punctuation. Now we will look our first sentence. The colorful yellow bird sings so beautifully. So in this sentence, its beginning letter is in small letter. So we will write this in capital letter. So start writing with me. Write down number 1. The colorful, COLOURFUL, colorful yellow bird, YELLOW, yellow, BIRD, bird. Look student, bird is a common noun, so we will not write its first letter in capital letter. Okay, we only write the names in capital letter. Yellow bird sings so BEAUTIFULLY, beautifully. At the end of this sentence, we will put full stop. Now look at number 2 sentence in our textbook. Rajesh will come on Tuesday. Student, Rajesh is a naming word. It is a proper noun and it is in the beginning of the sentence. So we will write this R in capital letter. So write down number 2 in your notebook. Rajesh, R-A-J-E-S-H, Rajesh will come on Tuesday and it is a day name, so that we write its first letter in capital. On Tuesday, 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 and at the end of this sentence we will put full stop. Now look at number 3 sentence in our textbook. Hatim and Jainab are going to Mysuru. In this sentence, its first word is a proper noun and it is a name and it is a beginning of this sentence. Student, it is a name. So we will write its first letter in capital like this. Write down number 3 and write the name of Hatim. H-A-T-I-M, Hatim, and next one is Jainab and it is also a proper noun. So we will write its first letter in capital. It is a name. So we will write its first letter in capital. Jainab are going to Mysuru. Student, Mysuru is a place name, so that we will write its first letter in capital. M-Y-S-U-R-U, Mysuru. And at the end of this sentence, we will put full stop. Now, I would like some chocolate too. As we learned now that we will write pronoun I in capital letter wherever it appears. I, W-O-U-L-D, would like some chocolate too. And at the end of this sentence, we will put full stop. Now, look at number 5. Holi is a very colorful festival. And its beginning letter is in small letter. So, we will do it in capital. Start writing with me. Holi is a very colorful festival. Full stop. Now, look at number 6. In our textbook, Anna could not find her bottle. Anna, it is a name, so we will write its first letter in capital. Anna could not find her bottle. And at the end of this sentence, we will put full stop. Now, take out page number 1 in your textbook. Today, we will know how we use these capital letters and full stop in our books. Now, look at number 1 sentence. One night, Meena could not sleep. Look, student, its first letter is in capital. Then, Meena. Meena is a proper noun. Meena is a name, so that its first letter is in capital. and at last we put full stop. Now look, in next sentence, she sat up in bed and looked out of the window. She, its first letter is in capital letter, and at the end of this sentence, here is a full stop. She could see the moon. In this sentence, its first letter is in capital, and at last, here we put full stop. It looked like the moon was laughing at her. And again, student, look, its first letter is in capital, and then full stop at the end of this sentence. Now, we will move ahead. Don't look at me like that, moon, she said. Don't, and it is a first letter of this sentence, and its first letter is in, it is a first word of this sentence, and its first letter is in capital. And then moon, here Meena said the moon with its name. Moon is the object and its name is moon, so that here its first letter is in capital. You don't know, and its last, and at the last of this sentence, here is a full stop. You don't know what really happened today because it was in the morning. Look, student, its first letter is in capital, and at the last of the sentence and the end of the sentence, here is a full stop. Now we will move ahead. She tried to go back to sleep. In this sentence, its first letter is in capital, and at the end of this sentence, here is a full stop. The clock went tick-tock, tick-tock, and in this sentence, its beginning letter is in capital, and at the end of this sentence, here is a full stop. Meena thought the clock was saying, "I know, I know." Meena, it is a proper noun, and it is a name of a girl, and its first letter is in capital. Then, look, I told you, na? We write I always in capital letter wherever it appears. Now, it is appearing in the middle of the sentence, but we wrote it in capital, okay? And at the last of the sentence, here is a full stop. Now, you will understand how we use the capital letters and the full stop. It means the beginning of the sentence, we always put a capital letter, and at the end of the sentence, we put full stop. And we always write this pronoun I in capital letter wherever it appears. Okay? And we always write a proper noun, yani kisi ka name, with capital letter wherever it appears. Okay? Hope you will understand very well. Now, student, take out its page number 36. The big picture. What are you looking in this picture, student? This is a picture of water animals. It is a picture of under the water. And as you know that the water animals are live in. Now tell me, what do you see in the picture? First of all, tell me, where do animals live? Animals live in the land and in the water. But where do the water animals live? Water animals live in the water. Now tell me, what do you see in the picture? In this picture, we can see many fishes. Is this world the same as the world around you? Now tell me, क्या ये जो world है वैसा ही है जैसे हमारे चारों तरफ है? है ऐसा? नहीं है. क्यों? What is the different about it? क्या different है इसमें और हमारे जो चारों तरफ हमारे environment है उसमें? क्योंकि इसमें अंतर क्या है? यहाँ पर चारों तरफ पानी है. और क्या हमारे चारों तरफ पानी होता है? नहीं, हमारे चारों तरफ हवा होती है, है ना? हम लैंड में रहते हैं और वाटर एनिमल्स वाटर में रहते हैं. नाउ लुक एट नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन. वॉच दिस वीडियो टू लर्न मोर अबाउट द वर्ल्ड अंडर द सी. लुक स्टूडेंट, दिस इज अ लिंक. When you go in this link, you can see many water animals. And by this link, you will be able to know about these water animals. Do you know the water animals' name? Which are they? They are whales, shark, tortoise, jellyfish, starfish, crab, octopus and so on. Now tell me, can you think of other place where animal can live?
क्या आप दूसरी जगहों के बारे में भी जानते हैं जहां जानवर रह सकते हैं? Yes, some animals live on land, some animals live on trees.
Would you want to live in this underwater world? क्या तुम इस पानी के नीचे वाले संसार में रहना चाहते हो? अगर रहना चाहते हो तो क्यों? क्यों? क्योंकि ये बहुत सुंदर लगता है. मे बी आपको ऐसा लगे ना कि माँ, मैं इसमें रहना चाहता हूँ. कितनी सुंदर सुंदर इसमें फिशेस हैं, कितनी अच्छी जगह है. लेकिन क्या हम इसमें रह सकते हैं? नो, इट इज नॉट पॉसिबल. हम इसमें नहीं रह सकते. क्यों? क्योंकि पानी में हम सांस नहीं ले सकते हैं. वी कैन नॉट टेक ब्रीथ इन द वॉटर. नाउ लुक एट अवर नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन. इमेजिन दैट यू आर अ टाइनी क्रिएचर
लिविंग
ऑन अ ब्यूटीफुल फ्लावर. कल्पना करिए कि आप एक छोटे से प्राणी हैं और आप ब्यूटीफुल फ्लावर यानी खूबसूरत फूल पे रहते हैं. व्हाट वुड द वर्ल्ड अराउंड यू बी लाइक? व्हाट वुड द वर्ल्ड, आप किस तरीके का संसार अपने चारों तरफ रहना पसंद करोगे? हियर टॉक अबाउट इट इन क्लास लिखा हुआ है, बट नाउ वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट इट. है ना, अगर हम एक छोटे से कीड़े हैं और एक फूल को बहुत खूबसूरत फूल के ऊपर रहते हैं तो हमें किस तरीके का संसार चाहिए? एक साफ सुथरा जहाँ किसी प्रकार की कोई गंदगी नहीं हो, हवा में सब कुछ साफ सुथरा हो और आपको कोई भी ना पकड़े, ऐसा ही तो? हाँ, तो अब आपका काम क्या है? आप इस लिंक पे जाएंगे और वाटर एनिमल्स के बारे में जानेंगे. क्यों जानेंगे? क्योंकि फ्रॉम टुमारो वी विल स्टार्ट अवर चैप्टर सेकेंड एंड इट एंड इट इज बेस्ड ऑन द वॉटर एनिमल्स, सो दैट आप इस वीडियो को जरूर देखेंगे. ओके ओके स्टूडेंट, गुड बाय. बी सेफ, स्टे सेफ एट योर होम. गुड बाय एवरीवन.